This is the first episode, and here we'll create necessary files, import font, icon, images, and set up sass. There are two different ways to add Bootstrap in your project. The first one is to install via package manager, and the second one is to include via CDN. For this tutorial, I'm gonna use both of them. To include JavaScript, I will use the CDN method. And to work on sass, I will use the npm package. Before using npm, make sure you have Node installed on your machine. If it is not, you can go to the official website of Node. You can download and install them. After adding Node, you can copy this command line. You can then open your code editor. In my case, I'm using Visual Studio Code. You can create a folder. I'm using business. Then to open the terminal, click View, Terminal. You can then paste the command line and hit Enter. Once it is installed, you can see package.json and the node module folder. Inside that folder, you can see popper.js and the Bootstrap folder. And inside Bootstrap, you can see different JavaScript and the sass files. Now, let's create necessary files and folder. Let's create the most important file, which is index.html. Then, let's create some folder. So first, create the folder for the scss, then create another folder for css. We also need some images, so for now I have added them in my desktop. These are all the images that is required for this project, so I will simply cut them and paste them inside my project folder. If you want the images, you can get it from my GitHub account. Inside scss, let's add custom.scss. Then inside the CSS folder, let's add style.css. Now, let's add some code inside index.html. So go back to Bootstrap website, click Docs, and let's copy this code because it has included the Bootstrap CSS and the JavaScript file. Change the title to your project name, which is business. We don't need to import this Bootstrap CSS because we will be using the sass for this project. So instead, let's import the style.css from the CSS folder. This is for the Bootstrap JavaScript, so let's just add the comment. To add the sass, under Customize, click on sass. Our current structure is something like this. So this is our project folder, we got scss folder and have created custom.scss. Then we have got node module folder and the Bootstrap folder. It has got several JS and scss file. So to import the Bootstrap CSS, you can copy this import. So let's add them under custom.scss. Now this scss need to get compiled into style.css. So at the bottom in the terminal, you can add sass what. Our scss is under scss folder, and the name of the file is custom.scss. then we need to compile them under style.css, which is under the CSS folder. Once ready, hit enter, and you can see the message SAS is watching for changes. Now we can save the change. If you go to the style.css, you can see all the CSS file is automatically added over here. Now let's check the preview. So you can drag and drop index.html into the browser, and you can see hello world over here. Let's try to add some style. So in h1, I want to add red color to make sure this SAS file is working or not. Refresh, and it seems our SAS is working. Now let's also add some Bootstrap component to make sure the Bootstrap is working or not. So under the components, click buttons. You can copy any button. I will just copy this primary button and add them after the h1 tag. Check the preview, and we can see the Bootstrap primary button. It means our Bootstrap is working fine as well. Now let's import the font awesome. So in new tab, you can search font awesome 6 CDN. You can open the first link, and you can copy this link tag and paste them at the top just after the title tag. Then let's also add the Google font. So open new tab, you can search Google font, open the first link, and let's search for the font called Montserrat. Remove the existing font if there is any. Then for this current font, I want the regular and the semi-bold font style. Once done, copy the link tag and paste them after the font awesome 6. Then copy this font family and add them in custom.scss. Let's remove this h1 and instead add them under the body. So our font family is Montserrat. And let's also add some other CSS properties like font size, line height, and font weight. Once done, check the preview, and we can see our Google font has been implemented over here. Now in SCSS folder, let's create another file, variable.scss. Here we will add the primary color. To get the color code, let's go to the website, use developer tool, and let's copy this blue color. Then we will also add the white and the black color. Similarly, let's also add the primary font family. So our primary font is this Montserrat, so I will just copy and paste them over here. Now, in order to use this variable.scss under custom.scss, on top, you need to import variable. Now, where it says font family, we can simply add primary font family. Check the preview. And the font is still working. Great. Now, let's check the demo of our project. So this is the business website we will be using for this tutorial. We got the header, hero section, about us, our services, themes, frequently asked question in accordion, contact us, and future. By the end of this course, you will get confident creating project with Bootstrap. This is the end of this session. In the next session, we'll work on the top bar to add contact info and social media icons. Feel free to comment below if you have any questions. Also, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my channel to get more videos in the future. Thank you.